Good morning, guys. Lily Ann from Lily Ray's Collection. I am back with a new project. I know that I have to still complete the oh my goodness, I forget the unicorn. We were doing this when I last recorded. I will finish this. All we need to do is decorate the front. But that will be on the next video. I of course started experimenting because I've seen so many boxes out there. I wanted to make a box to either put my flowers or even to put a 4x6 book in here. So this is my prototype. As you can see, it says top of the lid there. This is side of the lid there, right there. This is back panel, and then bottom of the lid. So I put it all together yesterday, and I really want to do this with chipboard. But I did another one just like this with the cardstock. And this is the example that I have for you. And I added the decorative corners. This is the front of the box. This has a magnet right in here. See that? And then last night I added the legs with hot glue. Hope you can see that. Let me see. Yeah. Those are the legs. Let's turn it around. Side panel. It's the back of the box. I wanted it to be vintagey, vintagey, vintagey. Now, the legs don't look too sturdy, but of course you're not going to put something that's too heavy. I don't like the glue because you could see, I don't know, the blob. But anyway, again, this one's for me because it is a prototype. But right here I added some charms, a leaf, a little boat, the key, and this actually some ribbon, and then this is actually a lock. So what I did was put a magnet in it, and then this is the inside of the box. And I thought that maybe as you travel the world, you collect, you know, different types of stamps that represent where you've been. So that was my thought. And then the inside, that's the inside of the box. I think it came out lovely. And then I added another sticker here with a bottle like this on here. I don't know if you could see that. But and then I'm gonna add the two little ribbons for the flap of the box, even though it doesn't go anywhere, just decorative element. But I think it came out okay. And this is just with 110 pound cardstock, and then the actual cardstock. So white like this, 110. And then the actual cardstock. I love the way it came out. I didn't do anything on here because I don't know that I want to. Maybe I'll do something later, but again, it was about it being a prototype and it's pretty sturdy. Okay. I love the legs. I wish they were sturdier, but I have to kind of think about the legs. But I love it. So, if you want to learn how I made that box, then stay tuned. Okay, this box is going to be larger than the than this one. This one fits about a 4x6. This one's going to fit a 5x7, I hope. I haven't done a prototype of this. This is just on screen, and we're going to do it with chipboard. So first, I have to cut out the templates. which I can do. I have my rotary cutter here, so let's see how I can do this. Now these lines, I've made them where you can cut like right on top of that line. And these are what holds or gives the box sturdiness. And I gave you a perforated line inside the box so that you know where your half is. Let's try this again. I don't think I have enough light here. Alright, well, you get the gist. I'm going to cut everything out because these are going to be my templates. I haven't even created my book for the templates. I'm going to cut the rest of this out and then I will be back. Okay. I was missing a couple of pieces. So we have two of these, right, which is for the front and back, and then we have the side pieces, right, and this is the bottom. You could do it either way, on the bottom of the box or on the inside of that box. Yesterday I did it on the inside of the box like this. I sat it up like this, and these peaks, if they're a bit too long, just clip them a little bit. Okay, now, the reason I doubled up in the back here is because I wanted it to be extra sturdy, because I was thinking about using chipboard, but I figured not everybody can afford to use chipboard. So I'm going to make a box that will last you a lifetime and will be as hard as chipboard, as sturdy as chipboard. So I'm going to just take this piece, right, and butt it up right against there. No, I'm sorry, it has to go here because this is the flap. Here it is. There, like that. Right, and then this one's gonna be here. You get the gist. All right, let's put this together. Now, putting it together, let me just cut these little tips. I wanted to make this as easy as possible. So you print out your template, and then you just cut those tips and put everything together. And this is 110 card stock. You have your flaps, if they're too long, I mean not the flaps, your, what are these? These are the ones that kind of put together. I forget what you call these. They go like this to attach it to make the box sturdier once you've put the box together. Okay, so let's just double check this. It's just a hair longer, so I'm going to go ahead and measure it that way. And then I'm going to take the opposite piece, which we may not need, but we'll see. We have it just in case. All right, and then here, another hair. And then let's double check these pieces. And then I will make the adjustment on my template. Right, that goes on the inside. Just like that. So now, let's go ahead and put the box together. Don't need my scissors. Everything should be just right. Cross your fingers. Okay. So now, I'm going to put this, the brown ink that's on it, on the outside of the box. I'm gonna do this one first. I think I'm gonna do this one on the outside. Because the bottom is gonna be covered. And I did it yesterday with my glue. I think today I'm gonna use tape. Let me get my 2-inch. This one. This is just regular double-sided tape. It's not scrapbook.com. So I can find it. Okay, so I'm going to leave it like that. I want to have to ink everything up. I didn't, well, you know what? Put the brown line on it so that you wouldn't have to worry about inking it up. So if you want to ink it up a little more, I'm going to do mine at the end because really all that is going to be covered. And the flaps again is just to make your box sturdier. Could also use cereal boxes. You cut the box down to 8.5 by 11, send it to your printer, and you can print on it. Okay, so that's this one. It's gonna go like that. And then this one for the front. Putting it right underneath the fold. I wouldn't suggest ATG tape for this because you need to make sure that your box is going to stay together. So I use both the double-sided tape and the liquid glue. But remember that your liquid glue does warp the paper a little bit. So if you don't want the warped look, don't do it. Okay, so I'm gonna take, why didn't you score this? Oh. Take these out. I'm sorry that I'm speaking low. My husband is working from home today, so I hope you guys can hear me. Going to angle it upward, making sure that it's even from end to end. Oop. I don't want to get my head in the way there, but it's not gonna work. Let me just bring this down a little more until I position it. I can just push it in. This is all going to be covered up, so it doesn't make a difference. Okay? And if you're going to use the box to make a shabby chic, which I am going to, and you don't need the brown perforated lines, you can just turn it around. Put the tape on the opposite side. So instead of using, you put the tape on this side if you don't want the brown lines. I'm right-handed, so I have to do it this way. Let's go ahead and pull that. So far, so good. Now, oh look, I tore through that one. That's gonna go like this. Right. I should have done the same as this so that they're not loose like that. Maybe I'll do that. But for right now, we're going to use what we have. So this one goes here. And then this short end goes here. All right, so I'm going to do this first. I'm going to do it on here first. Let me bring this down. That's where the hole is on the bottom. And again, you know, you don't usually need so much lip, but because I'm working just with paper, no card, no chipboard, I want the box to be sturdy. The only thing that's going to be made of chipboard is going to be my lid. That's it, because I want it to be a bit heavy. And these I have not put on my Etsy shop as of yet. So once I'm done with this, if everything works out, then I will go ahead and download the file to my Etsy shop. I may as well do the other one. This can get a little boring and tedious, but I don't want you to miss what I need to do, you know, so just fast forward if you know a couple of these steps. I'm trying to move as quickly as I can. Burnish your tape. Really? All right, so we're going to take this out off. Handed. So actually, this is supposed to go inside. Yee. Inside the box. Let me just butt it up against it. This is that way. Just didn't want my head to get in the way. Tip to tip. Oh geez. Right. How am I gonna do this? Did it yesterday, no problem. Oh, I see. It goes this way like this. I'm confusing myself. Here we go. beauty is, and then that one goes here on the inside. Let's do the other one. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to add these wings to these before I print out the template again to be purchased, make everyone's life easier. I think that perforated line helps a lot. Okay, and that one goes on the inside like that. I'll get my head in the way. That's good, this one just needs to be. Now, these are in. Let's go ahead and do these. I should use my pokey tool. Just, I can't see. Let me stand up. Oh goodness. If I get this, once it's stuck down, it's stuck down. Let me see, maybe I should do it like this. These lines seem to help me visually. See that? Those lines are. They're for a reason. That's your gusset. One went right, the other one, of course, wouldn't. Let me do it this way. Okay. Alright. So now we can tape it like that. These I want on the inside. Yep, just like that. And then once you put your strap here, that's going to help right there. Alright, so with this, excuse me, with these flaps, I'm going to put an X because it's just the inside of the box, the lid. Let me put the X on these. I think that's going to be plenty. Fold them in. Let's fold one corner first. Make sure that you get the corners nice and even. This is going to be covered up with decorative paper, so. Okay. Oops. Alright. Push that tape inwards. Alright, and then this one. Oh, did I put it on the tape on the wrong side? You gotta be kidding me. Side. Oh Lordy B. I still need the tape for whatever I'm going to use inside. So, here's how you fix the boo-boo. I'm working on glass, so it's not a big deal. Oh my god. What a knucklehead. Lucky for me, I'm working on glass. Oh my gosh. Let me just get my corners together. It's okay that that's... OMG. Now just turn it this way and do the rest of the tabs. Or the tabs. Done and done. And now the first thing you gotta take care of is that which my tapes are sticking to. Okay. It's square. It's good. This We'll go here. And this will go here. Voila. And the tape is going to stick to that. So these panels, I'm definitely going to use this tape. Oh, thunder's coming again. Let's see. Gotta put it down carefully. Just like this. You pinch it. Look at what I did. Oh my god. This is just not working out for me. And then. That's okay. That's gonna be covered. But you know, you don't want a sloppy box. Push it right out. Now it's flat. Next one. Okay, right up against that perforated line. Because you know that it was measured. Don't pull outward. And there we have it. Your box is square. Beautiful. Excuse my sniffling. My sniffles. And then you have this to put on the inside just to make it even sturdier. And that's because, again, we are not making this with chipboard. So we're going to go ahead. Whoops. This is really sticky tape. Angle it, put it right in that corner. Push it all the way down. It should fit perfectly. Let's do the next one. Uh-oh. And knocked my computer out the last 2 days. you want to do one side first and then the other. If you wanted to paint the box, you could gesso it to give it some tooth. And and paint it. You don't have to put paper on it. But it is one sturdy box. We didn't have to guess at anything. And you have a completed box. Wait till we decorate it. Maybe I'll do this one shabby chic. Because it is one sturdy box. Okay, now this one goes right just on the back. Do I want it on the inside or the outside? I think I'm going to do the inside. Here. Yeah, I'm gonna do it on the inside. It's probably me cutting crooked right on top there. You could see it. Should be a quarter inch all the way around. I'll make sure it should be, yeah, it should be the same. Yep. Mm-hmm. All right. Like that, I won't have the actual lip. So on the inside I have the lip. And if you need to add it a little, an awning, you just add it. And just tape it. And see what happens. So I should have used my other scrapbook.com tape. I have sheets. good place to test it on. So we have that down. Excuse my sniffles. I do apologize. This always reminds me of a chocolate box. And there it is. So this is the large, I'm calling them my treasure keepsake box. Alright, so now I'm going to cut 5x7. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the video here, and then in the next go around, we're going to decorate it. So I'm going to cut a chipboard for the top. That is the only thing. And then the rest of it gets the decorative paper. So I will see you in the next part. All right, guys. Take care.